They return to Ohio Stadium as the Buckeyes take the field, led by Dan Stultz. He was fired up all day, and Stultz, a very good day for the Buckeyes. We'll start it off.
Our football team was ready to play early in the game. We came out here. That's Duckett now. You're talking about a big, strong running back. He's a good football player. We got him down. We jumped offside early in the game, gave him a key first down. And, you know, now they keep the drive going. Here they run the inside outside zone. Again, Duckett, you think he's going to overpower you, but he's more of a speed type back. He's got great speed also.
255 pounds, and he can move, and Michigan State bringing some fans along with them.
Yeah, nice drive, and we hit him in the backfield. And you can see you got to wrap him up. As you mentioned, he's 200. That wasn't Duckett there. That was the other running back.
But it was little John Flowers blossoming into the end zone for 7-0 Michigan State lead.
We come back here. I thought Derek Cohn played an outstanding football game for us. We came out early, trying to establish a running game. That's about a 15-yard gain. Good blocking goal by our tight end, Darnell Sanders.
Now you head to the passing game and go up top for 14 yards.
Chad Cascio. Steve did a nice job finding Cascio. We got him isolated on a strong safety. Their corners are pretty good. Number 32 is a good safety for them. Made a lot of tackles.
Good mix of run and pass in this first drive.
Try to mix it up. Coach Stobart called the plays. There's Chad again. No, that's Darnell Sanders. Excuse me. Darnell Sanders, a tight end. A little tight end hook route.
Pickup of 9 and a 47-yard field goal.
We got sacked, Jeff, on third down. I think it was 3rd and 11. We got sacked, and Danny Stoltz came in and kicked a 47-yard field goal. Danny's having a good year kicking the football for us.
7-3 at that point, but it's back to Michigan State. They put together two solid drives back-to-back.
They tried to do the same thing against us that Purdue did a week ago. Spread us out a little bit, try to isolate their wide receiver on one of either a strong safety or defensive back. Ran the option play. We overrun the ball, and their freshman quarterback's a good football player. Jeff Smoker scored their second touchdown on the option.
Smoker on fire early there. 13-3, Michigan State takes the lead, but you come right back with a nice special teams
play.
Good
kickoff return here by Kenyon Rambo, our captain. You see some good blocking. We work hard on this. Coach Conley's in charge of kickoff return. We are leading the conference in kickoff returns and punt returns, so that phase of the game's been good for us.
And Chad Cascio, you mentioned him earlier, he had three catches on this drive that were critical.
Again, third down play, that's a possession down. We did the same thing to Michigan State that Purdue did to us last week. Came out there and were pretty successful on third down, throwing the football to our inside receiver.
Go up top maybe one too many times here.
Got a little slant pattern, the ball is a little bit underthrown. And I tell you, Michigan State's got two good corners. That's number 37 is a good football player, number 15 is a good football player.
Cedric Henry there, the interception and the return. Out to about midfield there, and it's T.J. Duckett again.
T.J. Duckett, we stop him there. It's Matt Wilhelm, number 35, our middle linebacker. Settled down as the game went on, a good stop. We came with a lot of pressure on them also, as you can see. We didn't do a very good job of handling pressure. Michigan State didn't do a very good job either. Who's that, Derek Ross? No, that's Michael Doss, number 2, made the sack.
Loss of 6 on the play. Forces them to turn the ball over to the Buckeyes and back up top.
We get the ball back, and we're going to turn it over again. A nice play again by their safety. He's a good player. Number 32 will probably make all-conference as a free safety. Did a good job on the... It's a fourth down play here. Smoker keeps the ball. A good tackle by Nate Clemens, number 20. But they do pick up enough yards there for a first down.
Pick up a 3 on the play, just enough for the first. And then the defense turns it up a notch again in a passing situation.
Get after him. That's a good sack right there by Brent Johnson. And this to me, is the turning point of the ball game. That's Michael Doss picking the ball up. What did he go,
73 yards,
73
coach.
Yards, yep. For a touchdown and put us right back in the game. They're on top 13-3. And it looked like they're going to get some more points. And all of a sudden, it's 13-10.
And the Bucs are back in it, and obviously a momentum change, and the defense is fired up for that. Their 6th touchdown of the year.
Great pressure. That's Captain Rodney Bailey, number 94, putting pressure on their quarterback, sacking the quarterback. We used our timeouts, got the ball back here right before halftime. And this is a little screen pass that we've been successful at with this the last couple of weeks, getting the ball to Derek Combs in the open field.
Hitting that tailback. Wasn't used much in the beginning of the season, but very effective now at this point of the season.
Coming back to him there. They got to stop. And now watch this. It's another drive right before halftime. This is Captain Joe Cooper, number 10. Again, a good play by the defense. Give the ball a good offensive field position here right before halftime.
Great turning point there as well because of what had happened within a previous punt on that play.
A couple minutes left to go in the first half. A good catch here by Kenyon Rambo. Kenyon goes up. Stevie kept the ball inbounds. Good play right there by our captain, Kenyon Rambo, number 4.
40 yards on the pickup there, and Dan Stultz called back.
We ran a little draw play there right before halftime, trying to set up a field goal to get us in position to tie the ball game. I thought if we can go in the way we played in the first half, Jeff, we can go in with a tie. We're going to get the second half kickoff. It would be to our advantage.
Absolutely. And the turn of events that happened down in the last few minutes of that first half, you had to feel fortunate to be back in a tie.
Well, absolutely. We were not doing a very good job protecting our quarterback. We were taking some negative yardage. I didn't want to take a negative play in that situation. I know some of the fans were booing, whatever. I guess that shows you how much they know about college football. But, you know, there's one thing you do in college football. You win the surest way. And if you can get points on the board right before halftime and go in with a tie, when you're playing at home, you're going to get the second half kickoff. I think you do it every time.
You take your chances in the second half with a tie ball game. 30 minutes of football left. We've got the highlights from the second half coming back on Buckeye Football Weekly. State should be no different. You blitz them as you come off the bus, even as you get the second half started here. And you start with the ball, as you said, and Derek Combs, again, effective.
A good job there by Steve Belisari checking that play, a little option play where he kicked the ball outside to our speed man, Derek Combs. Good blocking on the corner by Reggie German and Kenyon Rambo. Number four, you can see Adrian Clark. Adrian comes to play our left tackle. Going to be a great player.
Another special teams play. This is big.
This might have been the key play of the game. This is a nice punt by Danny. Danny Stoltz is our what we call our pooch kicker. And good coverage down the field. That's Derek Ross down in the ball on their 1 yard line. We got them backed up. Plus the students really helped us right here. They could not hear their snap count. They had a couple of key penalties, motion penalties. And here we're going to get the ball in great field position. Nate Clemens makes a nice return. That was a right, a wall right, but he saw them overplaying that side of the field and took the ball. He got a 15-yard personal foul penalty against their football team for a change. Yep. So we got the ball in great field position. Watch Derek here. You're talking about great blocking now. Good blocking on the off-tackle play. We double down, kick out. Our fullback, Jamar Martin, got a good block. That's I'd like to see Mike Gurr down there helping the running back up. Number 65, Darnell Sanders, number 89.
Down to the 1 yard line there and a net of 13 yards on that whole play from the punt to the time you take it over in great field position already in the red zone.
That's how you run the quarterback sneak. Stevie jumped over the top of their pile in for about 2 yards in the quarterback sneak for a touchdown.
Here comes the D again, Rodney Bailey.
The defense really, really came to play in the second half. Great pressure. You can see we're getting after their quarterback. They can't handle the rush. Now, this is a coverage sack, though. Great coverage in the secondary. John Dedu, the coach of those defensive backs, does a great job. Allows Brent Johnson to get the sack, number 60.
Loss of one on the play, and then you bring the house again.
Here we come. The quarterback better duck, because we're coming after him. That's Brent Johnson again, number 60. Ended up with 3 sacks in the game. The defense really got pumped up in the second half.
Now you get another break, and this is good to see.
This is a key point right there. You're talking about close. We almost got that one blocked, and their safety mishandled the ball. You cannot advance that. That's a freshman down there. Robert Reynolds making a recovery.
Can't blame him for trying.
again, defense giving the ball in great field position by the offense.
Absolutely. This time it's Derek again.
Some inside running play. They crowded up inside, and Derek uses his speed out of Grove City right here just south of Columbus. Derek's having a great year for us. That's against the number one rushing defense in this league.
And that's 27-13. Buckeyes on top in this ball game.
And they got to score twice now to beat us. And they go to their tight end. They try to do the same thing Purdue did against us last week. But obviously, we made some adjustments from last week to this week and played that much better. Again, they hit their wide receiver coming out of the backfield, number 7. Good tackler, Michael Doss, Joel Cooper.
Now
this is where we screw up. I don't know why the center just didn't hold the football. Right. They yelled our snap count, and that's one of the strangest plays I think I've ever seen. He didn't even snap the ball.
Well, he snapped it to himself and then held onto it.
Yeah, then held onto it and got the ball knocked out.
Either way, it results in 0 points, so dodge a bullet there. Fire up the troops to get back out once again. The 30-yard field goal is no good.
We dodged the bullet. Now, they tried to hit us with a little screen. I had a little success, but we were rushing up front. A good tackle right there, Michael Doss, number 2. Michael's really a good football player. Donnie Nicky, our free safety, number 25. Michael Doss, of course, Nate Clements, one corner, and David Mitchell, the other corner, number 3. Here's Michael Doss, number 7. Good job, Michael. Protect the football.
Derek Ross there, number 7. You had the number right?
Derek Ross, yeah. Michael Doss, number 2. Derek Ross, number 7.
Great play.
Watch that block by our fullback. Boy, I like to see that. Off tackle, double down and kick out. Derek Combs getting the first down. We got real conservative, very conservative in the second half, but we did what we had to do to win the football.
You go up the middle for 9 yards, that's okay, and you get 6 around the end.
Second and 4. They got a little motion penalty, and that's Will Smith right there making the play, along with Tim Anderson, number 54, and Will. Both those guys are freshmen.
That's right.
Will's number 83, a true freshman.
That was backup quarterback Ryan Van Dyke in there because Jeff Smoker reduced to a smolder there in the end of this game as the Buckeyes reel off 24 straight points in that game. You have to like that offensively.
Well, I like the way we came back. I don't like getting behind early in the ball game, but I do like the way we regrouped. I think the captains do a good job on this football team, keeping our team together, keeping our team focused. I think that's the difference in this football team this year and the team we had last year.
All right. Well, when we come back on Buckeye Football Weekly, we'll look